In this illustration, we'll discuss about some steel balls and mercury. We are given that some steel balls are fixed at the bottom of a silicon bulb of negligible expansivity. And it is given that a bulb holds 340 gram of mercury at 0 degrees centigrade when filled without the steel balls, and holds 255 gram of mercury when the steel balls are inside. It is given that in heating the bulb and its content to 100 degrees centigrade, 4.8 gram of mercury overflows. And here we are required to find the coefficient of linear expansion of steel, and that of mercury is given to us. Here in solution, we can write initially the volume of bulb can be given by the volume of mercury it is holding. This V naught we can write as 340 divided by density of mercury at 0 degrees centigrade, because the bulb holds 340 gram of mercury at 0 degree. And if we calculate the volume of steel balls, then volume of steel balls we can calculate this V naught, volume of bulb, minus the volume of mercury which is held by the bulb at 0 degree centigrade, which is 255 gram of mercury. So we write it 255 divided by rho of mercury at 0 degree centigrade. Now, as we are having the volume of bulb as well as that of a steel ball, so we can now calculate the volume of mercury overflow when the temperature of system is raised to 100 degrees centigrade. So, volume of mercury which is overflowing can be simply given as the expansion in volume of steel balls plus the volume of mercury in it. So, that can be given as volume of steel balls multiplied by 3 alpha of steel multiplied by delta T. It is expansion in steel ball plus expansion in the amount of mercury which is there in it, which can be written as 255 divided by rho of mercury at 0 degree centigrade is the volume of mercury multiplied by gamma of mercury times delta T. And this is the volume of mercury overflown, and volume of mercury overflown can be written as 4.8 divided by density of mercury at 100 degree centigrade, which can be given as density of mercury at 0 degree centigrade divided by 1 plus gamma of mercury multiplied by delta T. And this equals to volume of steel balls, which if you substitute here, this gives us 85 divided by rho of mercury at 0 degree centigrade. So on substituting it, we are getting 85 divided by rho of mercury at 0 degree centigrade multiplied by 3 times alpha of steel multiplied by here delta T is 100 plus this 255 divided by rho of mercury at 0 degree centigrade multiplied by gamma of mercury multiplied by rise in temperature is 100. Here this denominator gets cancelled out in all the terms. And further, if we simplify by substituting the gamma of mercury as 1.8 into 10 to power minus 4, after simplification, this will give us a value 4.89 is equal to, and this term will be 25500 alpha of steel plus 4.59. Further simplifying, this gives us the coefficient of linear expansion of steel, which is 4.89 minus 4.59 divided by 25500. And on simplifying, this giving us the value 1.17 into 10 to power minus 5 per degree centigrade inverse. That is the result of this problem.